everybody, this is Colin, my real name, although just about all of you know me as JowerGator9. I guess this is a face reveal of sorts, although many of you have probably seen my face already, since it's on my Twitter account, and since I've been on some streams with Tom Grossi, Your Name Tree, and 5-Point Fids. Don't worry, that's not the big announcement or reveal from this video. It's much bigger, and it's much more important than that, and this is a video that I've wanted to do for a really, really long time. Quite honestly, it's a video that I never thought in a million years I would ever get the opportunity to make, but I'm getting the chance to, and it is all because of you guys. For those of you who just want to jump straight ahead to the announcement, I'm going to leave a timestamp down below because I have no clue how long this thing is going to take, but I just want to talk a bit about myself and what I've been doing for the past 3 or so years and how we got to the point that we're at today. So when I graduated from undergrad, this was back in May of 2019, I spent a good chunk of my time working in the athletic department for my school, and I broadcast hundreds upon hundreds of games on ESPN+, and even got to do some work with ESPN3. I loved every second of what I did. I spent practically all of my free time when I wasn't in class or hanging with my friends or watching football, just working for the athletic department on broadcasts. I would call games, I would do all the research myself, and my notes were extremely meticulous. I prepared for literally every scenario under the sun, and anyone who knows me well can attest to that. I would review footage from other broadcasts, I would create video clips to air during the games. Basically, I did a ton, and I absolutely loved it. But I knew when I was done with undergrad that this is not what I wanted to do full-time. Just didn't want to do it. It would have been a lot of traveling, a lot of nights and weekends away from home, the pay isn't great unless you're near the top, and I just didn't like the direction that broadcasting in general was going in when it came to tons of remote broadcasts where you're calling in from a studio and where you had a bunch of athletes with no experience getting to jump the line and get really good positions. Plus, I'm way more comfortable doing color commentary than play-by-play, and good luck making it as a color commentator if you did not play the sport at a high level. So with that, I knew that I needed to find something else to do. And with that, I went to law school. I got into the Sandra Day O'Connor College of Law at Arizona State, was a top 25 law school, and I started attending there in August of 2019, moving all the way out to Arizona by myself across the country and thinking about maybe going the player agent route. And what I found out there was that I had a ton of free time on my hands. It was like a whole new world opened up for me when it came to things to do, because all the time that I spent working on games and broadcasts and in the athletic department, I was no longer doing. And all the time I spent besides that hanging out with friends was gone, because all of my friends, for the most part, stayed close by where I went to college, and I was a lone wolf all by myself, knowing absolutely no one, with nothing to do besides law school. So I had a ton of time to kill, and this was right around the time that certain creators on YouTube were starting to blow up and rise in popularity. I watched guys like Secret Based and Your Name Tree all the time in college, and I thought to myself, why can't I do that? I've been making posts on the NFL subreddit ever since 2014, and those were really well received, and I love making those. But I thought to myself around this time, why can't I just convert those history posts to videos? There's not really a channel out there that focuses on obscure and random stuff in NFL history, and there's not really a channel out there that dives into the weeds of random newspaper articles and tries to find some of the craziest things that have happened in the long and great history of the NFL. Yeah, it would take more time to put together, especially since I would need to record the audio, find the footage, edit the audio, deal with all that, but I figured it was worth a shot. Why not venture out and see where this thing goes as a hobby? And for the first few months, that's all this was. A hobby to keep myself busy during my downtime at law school to prevent myself from going crazy. Law school and any social opportunities that came up always came first. This was just something I had on the side. I would try and get at least one history video up per week, maybe two if I had the time, and it started with the very first history video I ever put up, which was a redoing of a Reddit post I made a few years before that at a hotel room in Jacksonville about how Philadelphia, of all places, almost hosted Super Bowl 21. You can click the card in the upper right corner if you want to watch that and see how far I've come, because it is truly amazing how much more advanced the videos are nowadays. But for the most part, that's what this was, and doing this took about 6 months to hit 1,000 subs and get monetized and start making money from this, which just about blew my mind that over 1,000 people cared about what I was saying and like my videos enough, even though I had no idea what I was really doing editing-wise and pacing-wise, and really had no idea what I was doing. I knew when I was doing this that if I could do this for a living somehow, yeah, that would be amazing. That would really be amazing. Just being able to talk about NFL history on my terms and on my schedule, and just doing what I love doing anyways, but do it as a profession. But I wasn't really treating this as a business just yet. Again, this was just something on the side to keep me entertained during law school. And then March of 2020 happened, and the pandemic happened. And that's when everything really changed for me. I went back to live with my family in New York for 5 months because everything was shut down. Law school was virtual, and there was no reason whatsoever for me to be out in Arizona all by myself and all isolated with no human interaction at all. But when COVID happened, there was really nothing whatsoever to look forward to. Any social opportunities were gone. Any sporting events that I wanted to watch were gone. And with law school, grades did not matter anymore in the slightest bit because everything was pass-fail. Everything was open notes since you were virtual. And you have to actually try to fail a class. Like, you have to actually put in a concentrated effort to fail. My property law professor, who I loved, one of my all-time favorite professors there, he said that in the 10 or so years that he taught, and he was teaching about 60 students every spring in that and about 60 students every fall in water law, he failed 2 students. That's it. And one of them wrote nothing on the final, and the other one wrote 1 sentence. So let's just say grades at this time were not a concern in the slightest bit. And with that, it's as though I had all the free time in the world. COVID really shut everything down, and I had all this free time on my hands. And that was a real turning point for me, because it was at a moment where, in my mind, I had no excuses. I wasn't going anywhere. I wasn't hanging out with anyone. The whole world was shut down. I knew that if this was what I wanted to do for a living, I couldn't treat it as a hobby anymore. I figured with the pandemic that I was going to post a video just about every single day. It wasn't going to be easy, I knew that, but I was going to find a way to do it. And then I kept doing it every single day, even once the pandemic passed, even once everything started opening up again. And even as the videos got longer and longer and longer, the vids went from 3 or 4 minutes to 6 or 7 minutes to 10 minutes to 12 minutes to now an average of about 15 or 16 minutes, some even in the 18-minute range and some of them in the 25-minute range. I just kept grinding and I kept going because my mindset has always been to go bigger and better in everything that I do. Not once did I ever think about taking days off or making the videos what they were in early 2020 lengthwise, because I don't really like to go backwards. And I was doing everything by myself. I still am. So I had no help whatsoever along the way. So between researching, writing the scripts, recording the audio, editing the audio, finding the footage, putting everything together, designing the thumbnails, creating the community posts, dealing with any YouTube issues on the copyright front, creating the trivia questions, organizing the streams, moderating the streams, creating the graphics for the streams, any and all business operations, responding to emails, and then everything with the second channel that I added in Jaguar Gator 8 for college football, which has gone really well. It might hit 10,000 subs by the end of the year, which is nuts to think about how few channels have that amount, and I might have 2. Yeah, everything was all me. I had support from my family and from my friends, but in terms of the actual operation, it was all me. And I'm not gonna lie, guys, this really took a toll on me. It was incredibly hard to balance law school with the channel, putting out 9 videos a week, 7 on JG9, 2 on JG8. It was brutal having to get up early for class and study and write papers and work on presentations and do all of that, and then work super late into the night, especially during football season when I can't exactly start my work until the games are done, since my videos are about the games that take place. It really was a lot, and I knew that this was not sustainable in the slightest bit. Over the past 4 months, I've been sleeping quite literally whenever I've gotten the chance to. My life has been law school, work, and sleep. That's it. My sleep schedule is completely shot. I was pulling all-nighters, going to bed at 5:30 a.m. most nights to wake up at 7:30 for class. And for me, if I could go to bed before the sun rose, that was an early night for me. Mentally and physically, it was just draining to do all of that while getting my JD and while getting my master's in sport law and business at the exact same time. I knew that this couldn't last forever, and I had some serious thinking to do when I graduated law school. And we finally reached that point. It was a long 3.5 years getting 2 degrees concurrently on top of everything with the channel. And when it comes to the channel, I wouldn't trade it for the world. I really wouldn't. The community we built together is just amazing, and I'm blown away by how many people care about what I have to say. There are some nights where I'm just talking about random things on stream, and no one's left the stream, and it's 2:30 in the morning on the East Coast, and that always just blows my mind. There are some people that watch and comment on every single video. When you break it down time-wise and add the links of each video, they've spent a full week of their year just watching my content. And this has opened up so many opportunities for me, getting Andrew Siciliano and Scott Hansen to watch my Red Zone presentation from May 2020, when I did a mock Red Zone broadcast from week 2 of the 1988 NFL season, to John from Secret Base, one of my idols and inspirations for doing this, just shouting me out on Twitter randomly one night while I was eating pizza, knowing at that moment that this was going to change my life forever, to people literally donating money on stream to me and paying me on Patreon, which is crazy to think about. Seriously, if we take out the law school part and some of the nonsense of YouTube behind the scenes with their copyright issues, I can honestly say I've loved every minute of what I've done. But I can't devote my time to doing two things anymore. It's just too much for me. So we've come to a fork in the road, because as of yesterday, I officially graduated. I'm done with law school. I'm done with my education forever. No more classes, no more tests, nothing. I now have a very serious choice to make, and one of the biggest decisions in my life. I have two options in front of me. Option one is to work a nice, cushy legal job that would pay more reliable money, would give me a steady income, and would give me benefits while allowing me to work significantly fewer hours than what I'm working right now. Because I'm pulling over 100 hours a week as things stand, and anyone who knows me well knows that is not an exaggeration. Or option two, forget all of that and just jump into this full time and be a full time content creator on YouTube, bet on myself with no guaranteed income at all. And folks, this is a video I have wanted to make for a really, really long time. Because I truly never thought this day would come. I never thought I would get to say the words. I've dreamt about it, never thought it would be official. Not many people can say they do this. Because as of today, December 15th, 2022, YouTube is my full-time job. It truly feels surreal to be saying that. I fully acknowledge there is a ton of risk involved here. This is not a guarantee. This is a giant leap of faith. It might backfire spectacularly. But this is a chance that I'm willing to take. And it is all because of you guys and everything that you do for the channel. There are about 114 million YouTube channels out there, I just checked. And when kids grow up nowadays, a lot of them want to be content creators full-time. And to be one of the lucky few that can say that I'm one of them, it's just incredible. It's surreal. So as of today, I'm putting all of my eggs in one basket. We're going full speed ahead on YouTube. JG9 is my full-time job. Now, as for what this means, content-wise, when it comes to JG9, nothing's changing. You're still going to get daily uploads and all that about the NFL. But what this does mean is that we're going to be doing some other things that I wasn't able to do beforehand with the brand. I'll be able to hire people to help edit videos and get footage for JG8. I'll be able to branch out into other sports on other channels. I think baseball fans are going to like what's coming on that front in February. I'll be able to stream a bit more. Next year, we're going to do some Monday Night Football live streams on here, which is going to be awesome. I'm going to get a new apartment, and I'm going to build a studio so we can actually do streams like that, and I can show my face on camera in a really cool studio setting. Basically, this was a necessary step to take if I was going to expand the brand the way that I wanted to. And trust me, this is only the beginning. There is no time to rest on my laurels whatsoever. We are just getting started. And with that in mind, I'm going to be hosting a celebratory stream tomorrow night, Friday, December 16th, right here on YouTube at 8 p.m. Eastern. It's not on Twitch. It's going to be right here on YouTube. And just like our Twitch streams, you guys can pop in and ask anything and everything you want. I saw Tom Grassi do this last year when he went full-time. Love that guy. And I thought to myself as a way to give back and show my appreciation to you guys, because really, this is a celebration of you and this community, because this would not be possible without your help and your constant support, that if I ever had the chance to go full-time, in the really, really unlikely scenario that I would ever get to this point, that I would do the same thing and host a celebratory stream. So I hope you'll join me tomorrow night, Friday night, and we can celebrate this moment together right here on YouTube. So from the bottom of my heart, I really want to thank you guys, seriously. I'm living the dream, and it is all because of you. If you told me 10 years ago that I would be talking about football for a living and doing it on my own terms, I don't even know what I would say. I really don't know. I'd probably say that you guys are crazy. I probably would, but that's exactly what I've been given the opportunity to do, and it's all because of you guys. So truly, truly, I thank you guys for everything. After 3.5 long years of grinding, it is worth it for this exact moment right here. And I promise you, I won't let you down. We're taking a giant risk here, but it's a risk that I think is going to pay off. And I'm really excited for what's coming next, because I can promise you, this is only the beginning. And I will see you guys tomorrow night for a celebratory stream. And until next time, this is JRGator9 signing off.